I will, as Katy explained, I will try to answer this question to give you some hints about how the universities can help to take your innovation to the market. Along this, I think that yesterday and today you have been listening to different guys talking about different projects, and I will try to give this different view. About the agenda first, I will start with a brief introduction about myself and the center I'm working at, Deusotech. Second, I will give you a brief overview about the different paths connecting the lab to the market. Third, I will focus and concentrate on specifically for startups and entrepreneurs about why and how should you approach to the lab. Fourth, I will give a brief example about what we are doing at Deusotech. Yes, to conclude. So, why I'm here? I like to use this picture, which summarizes basically my career. On top of the picture, on the blue boxes, I've been working basically on the research and universities area, but also on the lower part you can see the green area. I have experience and I've been working also on the business sector. So I started in the R&D engineer. I started working with technology in this R&D and technology area, but also have experience in the business, the business development market. Later on, I started with some management issues, and lately I've been more involved also with some consulting and coaching startups and entrepreneurs. Some basic figures and data about Deusotech. Well, Deusotech is a research and technology center which belongs to the University of Deusto, which, as you probably know, is very close from here, just across the river, 1 kilometer away from here. And some basic facts, it was founded in 2005. We are around 120 people, quite a young team, 53.6 years rich age. And our turnover last year was around 4.5 million euros. We're also very active in Horizon 2020 projects. Two ideas about this vision. The first one is that we try to have this mentality of a startup, because we believe the opportunities don't happen, that we or you create them. And regarding to our values, to our vision, we believe in the excellence, technology, and ethics for the sustainable development of the society and business in a long-term partnership. So we are very well aligned with this topic of this forum and also the hackathon. So, as I said, a brief overview about the different paths connecting the lab to the market. On the left side, you can see the world of the research of the labs. People usually are typically creating ideas, new concepts, patents, new technologies. On the right side, you can see another world. It's the outside world, where companies, the organizations are working, creating, developing, manufacturing, and trying to sell, hopefully selling, products and services. And I put a thin blue line between both worlds. I sometimes think that there is a big wall, but there is here I put a thin blue line. So this is one of the. I will start with this path. This is technology push, and this is what I call it disruptive innovation. In this path, typically what happens is that the universities, the research, or the science are developing basic research, and after putting huge amount of resources, money, time, and after typically 15 years of development, this gets to the market. Typical example of this disruptive innovation would be GPS, the internet. A different path, in this case, is going from the market to the technology. In this case, is big companies, very big multinationals, IBM, Siemens, General Electric, enter into long-term relationships with the universities so that they can develop the technology that they need. The next path is more common or more feasible for companies, SMEs, and even some cases on startups. And typically, in this case, it could be both ways. In some cases, the companies are approaching to the universities so that they have a need, they have identified some technology challenge, they approach to the lab in order to have a solution. But also the other way around. Sometimes what happens is that some universities, through these technology and transfer offices, have developed patents, ideas, and are able to talk to some companies. Nowadays, it's becoming more common, this another approach, where some researcher at the university has developed a powerful and strong idea, some patent, and decides, normally with some help, decides to create a spin-off and bring this, this idea to the market. And last one, it's what, how the startups, from the market point of view, could approach to the lab, which I will explain in this slide. So, first question, why or when a startup or an entrepreneur like you are here should approach to the lab? Well, I assume that all entrepreneur and all startup has to try to produce an innovation. So I will start with that definition of innovation. Already you have read, there are many definitions. I particularly like this one from Eugene Pichelon from the MIT, which says that the innovation is the useful embodiments of ideas putting in the marketplace. So, according to this definition, every innovation needs to have these three elements, which I will describe now. So, at least in one of these universes, there should be innovation, at least in one of them. And of course, the rest of them have to be covered and taken into account when you are thinking about bringing to the market. So, technology refers to the technology that you need for innovation. In your innovation has to do with a new material, with a patent, with a new software. Market, I think, is quite clear. Of course, you need to market to put your product service, and it has to do with maybe it could happen a new market sector, it could be a new market region. An implementation, which is very important, and sometimes we forget about that, has to do with the regulations, the business model, the funding for your project, and so on. So as I said, if we want to have success, at least in one of them, there should be innovation, and the rest have to be covered. I will give you an example of a failure in this case. This is I don't know if you have this device. This is a mobile phone that we developed. I participated in this startup. It was 15 years ago, so it was quite old device. This is a mobile phone for the blind people. This is a mobile phone which text-to-speech that spoke load the message and the agenda that they have. So at that moment, we were very technology freakish. So we were convinced that our technology was the best, and probably it was very, very good at for the time being. So the technology was okay. There was market, as we see with some products. And we also had the implementation. We were in touch with, for example, with the ONCE, the Spanish Organization for the Blind People, for distribution. However, we missed something very important. We did not take into account the customer. When we showed this phone to the blind people, they did not like at all. Why? Because they said, "I want a standard mobile phone with that normal display because I don't want to feel stigmatized." So it was a failure. So when or why should a lab, sorry, so should the startup approach to a lab? If the innovation lies on the market, I think you don't need a lab. It lies on the business model, probably you don't need the lab. But if the innovation is based basically on the technology, maybe or sometimes you need to go to a lab. So, how should you approach, in my opinion, to a lab? I will try to give you some hints to avoid mistakes and pitfalls. So it's very important, and it will say it's critical, that you evaluate the technology challenge. If in your idea, if in your startup, the technology is key, and in order to have success, you need a very, very deep technology, you need to understand it very well. If you need a technology that it will take 10 years to develop with a huge amount of efforts and money, probably you will fail. So please don't neglect technology challenge. Even if you are not a technologist, take into consideration, study very well, which is the technology challenge, if any. An idea connected to that one is that the prototype is not a product. And this is typically a mistake that some people do not realize. You could have a prototype in 1 week, but maybe the product can be 1 year. So if you are going to engage in a project with a lab, or with other company in order to develop technology, you need to take into consideration that probably the budget will be higher and the development time will be longer. This is another example I wanted to share with you about a different system that we developed, another system I was working at. In this case, we developed a system to control air vents in elderly people's houses. Sometimes there are people suffering from a fever disease, and sometimes they just go out through the gate and they could get lost and have an accident. So in order to avoid that, we designed a system where we put some sensors at the gates, and the people were wearing some bracelets, as the one you can see on the image. So what happened? Well, among other mistakes, in this case, technology was not enough developed. Yeah. We were using RFID, which is a very cheap and standard technology. It worked quite well at the lab, but when you brought this product to the real market, sometimes it didn't work, especially when so many people were entering and leaving at the same time. There were interferences, and it happened that some people could go out and detect. So it was another example of failure about the importance of this technology.